We're about to see the Ducks take on the Preds, and you're watching Post to Post.
Hello and welcome to Post, the channel where we discuss all things hockey and all teams. This is the final video of this series where we tell you guys our favorite players from every single team. We've done the Atlantic, we've done the Metro, we've done the Pacific, and now it's time for the Central. And we've got some teams to get through here. So basically, we've chosen a favorite player from every single team. We're going to let you know who that player is and why we've picked that player for the most part. Maybe we won't have in-depth answers for our reasons as to why we've chose these players, but maybe we will. So I'll let you start it off and we can do it in this order.
And these are no specific order. They're just the order that we decided to hang them up. Chicago Blackhawks are first. The player I chose is a young fella who is going to be probably a franchise player. Alex DeBrincat.
Yeah, I chose him too.
He's 22. He's only 5'7", officially. Maybe he's a little more now. Maybe he's still growing for all I know.
I don't think so.
165 pounds. But what a fabulous player he is.
You know, is there any other reason why you chose him?
A little bit.
The Andrew Shaw trade.
Could have been Montreal's pick, maybe.
That's why I chose him.
Yeah.
Small player, really talented. Could have been a Montreal Canadian, but decided to, well, he didn't decide. Mark Bergevin decided that he didn't want that pick, and that pick ended up being Alex DeBrincat, which is crazy. So
crazy. Not that Shaw's not a good player. He is. He's a very good player. But he's Alex DeBrincat has a lot more potential in the future.
I agree.
Whereas Andrew Shaw's potential, some of it is already in the past.
He's plateaued, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good for Chicago.
Well, we're one for one.
Next, Winnipeg Jets. We might be two for two here. I picked the player. There's a lot of talented Winnipeg Jets players, but to me, it's not about talent. It's about the person. And this player loves hockey and would watch hockey even if he wasn't playing. And his name is?
Mark Scheifele.
You are correct.
Boom.
He just loves hockey. He loves the game. We talked about
get you some.
We talked about Ovechkin and Gallagher in the past. We'll be talking a little bit down the road here about a Dallas player who I have the same feeling for. Not for the same kind of energy, but his love for the game is unsurpassed on that team and probably in the league. For the love of the technical aspects of hockey, he just absolutely loves the game.
Absolutely. One of my favorite players in the league, Mark Scheifele, is an incredible two-way player as well. Such a hockey smarts and just a genuine good person. Like when he does interviews, it's not these robotic responses. Like he's actually having a conversation with the person interviewing him. And he's great.
Awesome. Next, we have Colorado. It's not easy. There's a lot of talent there.
There is a lot of talent.
A lot of talent and a lot of players that you can like. If I have no tiebreaker, if I'm looking at Landeskog and I'm looking at Rantanen and I'm looking at McKinnon, if I need a tiebreaker, I'll pick the local guy. So it's Nathan McKinnon.
Yeah, same here. I picked Nathan McKinnon as well. Are we three for three?
We are three for three so far.
I think Nathan McKinnon, like if you talk about the best player in the league, Most people are going to say it's Sidney Crosby. I would also say that, but there's a serious argument for Nathan McKinnon, like a serious argument. And just to watch him with the puck is incredible. It's not even close for me on the team. It's Nathan McKinnon. Yeah.
Right on. Next on the group, we have Dallas, the Dallas Stars.
I already know yours.
You already know mine because we talked about Ovechkin and Gallagher and Radulov. Alexander Radulov, who I watched with Montreal and I got to really like for that brief period of time he was there as a one-year free agent. And I was really disappointed that Montreal didn't keep him. He's not had as great a year this year as he did last, but he's still having a really good year. And it doesn't matter. It's not about your performance from one month to the next. It's about your absolute passion for the game of hockey. And he's got that. Mm-hmm. And I still really think he's one of my favorite players in the league. Just because of that energy.
He just has so much passion for everything.
Yeah.
And even, I'd say more so when someone else scores a goal, he gets more excited than when he scores a goal. So he actually like really loves the game of hockey. So he'd probably play for free if he could.
Yeah.
I didn't choose Radulov. I actually chose Jamie Benn. I just think that Jamie Benn is the exact example of a captain that you should have. He's a leader. He'll fight. He'll check. He'll score goals. He does everything. He is he does everything. Like, there's nothing that he doesn't do. Now, I understand he's had a little bit of a down year as we're filming this, but I still do really like Jamie Benn. So
cool. All righty. Next is the Nashville Predators. This was tough. This was tough because I've been a PK Subban fan for a long time, and I still am. But I don't have the same connection with PK Subban this year that I've had in the past, even when he went to Nashville early on.
I agree.
And I don't know what it is. I can't explain it. It's nothing he's done wrong, but I just don't have that same need to follow him and to keep an eye on how he's doing. And I still will watch every interview he gives.
Yeah.
Because he's a great interview, he's a fantastic humanitarian, and he still maintains very close connections with the fan base in Montreal for raising money for the hospital wing that he did. And he's still very much involved in charities. He does that fabulous thing in Nashville where he partners with a police officer and they find a troubled or an at-risk youth and bring them to the game. And you know, that's just fantastic stuff. So he always would get an honorable mention.
I agree.
But as far as my favorite player these days, I think it has to be Victor Arvidsson.
Is it really?
Yes, it is.
I also chose Victor Arvidsson.
Boom. So we're 4 for 5, I guess.
Wow.
Yeah. He's another small guy. And he went in the 4th round of the draft when he was drafted. So that's a message to some teams. We talked about a lot of our favorite players, our smaller players that went in the 4th round, 5th round, 7th round in some cases, and came to play when they finally got the chance.
Yep.
So it goes to, and you know, the game is changing too. That's true. The game is becoming a little less contact, less sticky, a little more speed. You can actually get around people because they're calling things like interference and that they wouldn't be calling even 10 years ago.
Mm.
So it's a game where a smaller player can thrive these days, but it's still, the general managers are supposed to know that. How come they're still drafting these guys 6th
exactly,
round?
Right? Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah.
So.
No, I totally agree. Victor Arvidsson is an amazing player. He will surprise you on the ice. He'll get you a goal when you need a goal. And I've always liked Victor Arvidsson. So.
Right on.
Yeah.
Next, we have the St. Louis Blues. We could be going 5 for 6 here.
We could be. I think we are.
I'm going Jake Allen.
Definitely Jake Allen. Yeah, he's a hometown boy. He's from Fredericton. I've spent the majority of my life around Fredericton, so easy choice for me. He's my favorite player in the NHL right now. So.
And even though he's had his struggles early in the season, the whole team has done a little bit better more lately, and he's still got a winning record by a couple of games. He's still got a goals against average under 3. He's had some stinkers, but he's done well at times too.
He's had some.
He's got a couple of shutouts this year. So good for him, but I follow him for mostly the same reason.
It's an easy pick, yeah. Don't need a lot of explanation. So
Minnesota, Mikko Koivu.
Yeah, definitely.
Wow. 6 for 7.
That's crazy.
That's pretty good. He's 36 years old. He's the rock of that team. He's been with them. And some of the other players, I didn't really mention it in some of these picks, but they're franchise players. Like Nicholas Cromwell from Detroit a couple of shows ago. He was drafted by Detroit. He's played for Detroit all of his life. He'll retire as a Red Wing.
Yep.
And I have the same sense of Mikko Koivu. I don't see him making any free agent splash in a year or two going somewhere.
But you would have said the same thing about Saku Koivu, too.
I would have. At the age of 36, he's still producing very, very respectable statistics for Minnesota. Yep. So he is bringing it.
Saku Koivu was my favorite player of all time.
Absolutely.
Ever. And because of that, I obviously started to watch his brother, Mikko Koivu, and the rest is history. So, yeah, easy choice. There's not even anyone else that I would even contend with Mikko Koivu on that team for me. So, yeah, that wraps it up. Thanks for joining me for these videos. I really appreciate
it.
I hope you guys liked them. Leave your favorite players down below in the comment section. We read all the comments. Please subscribe if you're not already. We'd definitely love that. And we will see you in the next video. Adios.